Hi everyone, this is Kruti Jaipancholi, Assistant Professor in LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. This video is about subject Microwave Engineering. So friends, in the last video, you learned about the various microwave measurement methods. How to measure the power, how to measure the noise, okay. So we learn all the methods to measure the power, we learn the measure to measure the noise, okay. So now in this video, we are going to learn the various microwave measurement. The measurement of the attenuation. What is the attenuation? So we know that the definition of the attenuation is, it's a measure of the reduction in the power level that experienced by the signal when it passes through the circuit. So now as you know that whenever the input signal that is there, now we obtain the output signal. Now when there is an input same as the output same as the input, we can say that there is no attenuation in the signal. Okay, so we need to measure the attenuation measurement, okay, in the microwave frequency. So attenuation measurements, okay, that is the result of the different effects. Which are those effects? So that attenuation that is due to the energy dissipated within the device as a hit, and due to that there is a reduction of the power through the device. Okay, so that is the one point, okay, by which the attenuation that may appear into the signal. Another thing that is the insertion loss of the device, okay, and that is due to the mismatch, okay, and the power losses, okay, would be there, and due to that the device, okay, that will not produce the hit, but in the other form, okay, the attenuation that could be there. So there is a method to measure the attenuation. So how can we measure? So it's a ratio of the input power to the output power, and it is expressed into the decibel. Now we know that when we are applying the input, so when you are applying the input to the signal, when your output is same as the input, there is no attenuation, and if there is a mismatch, the attenuation would be there. So attenuation ADV is equal to 10 log P input upon P output. Okay, so it's a ratio of the input power to the output power. So whenever you want to measure the attenuation, you need to take some value which is the unknown value. With that we can compare it and we can find it out. So if they are attenuation are the made by comparing the known value of the attenuation to the unknown value. Okay, so practical attenuation methods, okay, measurements, okay, that are normally the three methods. Which are those three methods? It is the RF substitution, audio and VC substitution, and IF substitution. Okay, so these are the three methods. By using it, we can measure the attenuation level. So first is the RF substitution attenuation. Now simply, first of all, we'll see that how can we have the simple value. So we have the signal generator which will generate the microwave frequency. It is given to the variable attenuator. So the attenuator, variable attenuation would be provided by the signal, and the detector will detect the signal, and the detected output that can be measured by using the power meter indicator. So it's a simple way to measure the attenuation that you are adding. Okay. So RF substitution method for calibrating the output reading. Okay. So now the second step in the RF substitution setup with the unknown load in the circuit. So that are the signal generator that we have. Now the signal generator output, it is given to the variable attenuator. Variable attenuator output is given to the unknown attenuator. And the unknown attenuator output that can be measured by the detector. So detector output we can measure it using the power meter indicator. So this way the unknown value we have a known value. By comparing those two value over here we are able to find out the attenuation. So what are the advantages of using this method? So in this method the indicator is read at the same location on the meter square scale for both the steps. Okay, that when you are measuring without putting the unknown attenuator, okay, and whatever the scaling that you have done, the same you need to keep. So this eliminates the scale reading error. You know that while you are reading using the multimeter, okay, every time you are just changing for different signals, then the all the units that can be also different. But if you will keep the same, then there is no scale reading error. Okay, so that it can eliminate the scale reading error due to the non-linearity of the meter itself. The second is the accuracy of the resultant value is directly depend on the accuracy and the calibration of the precision variable attenuator over its attenuation range. Okay, so accuracy that is also depend on to the calibration. Okay, disadvantage of this meter, that is the precision of the available attenuators is greater at the low frequency, but over here we are measuring that for the high frequency, so slightly the accuracy that is not good, okay, for the high frequency. The second method is referred to as a power ratio method. Okay, so power ratio method. Now in this method, the measurement of the attenuation that takes place into the two steps. Which are those two steps? It's very simple. The step number one, that is input power and the output power, okay, that can be measured in the microwave bench, okay, without inserting the device whose attenuation that could be calculated. I mean, I said the device under test, we are not putting in case of the step number one. In the step number two, the input and the output power power of the full microwave bench, that is done with the device whose attenuation that has to be calculated. Using the microwave bench every time when you want to perform the practical, initially you should not put the device under test. You have to find out that actual value. Okay, and by putting the device under test, you can just compare the values and you can find it out the answer. So the ratio of the two power, okay, when compared, give the value of the attenuation. Okay, so one power without the device, other power using the device, ratio of both gives me the result of the attenuation. So here the setup number one that you can see for the power ratio method. The microwave source which will generate the microwave signal is given to the attenuator. Two types of attenuators are available, fixed attenuator and the variable attenuator. Fixed attenuator provides a fixed amount of the attenuation and the variable attenuator that can be provide the variable attenuation. Okay, it is given to the frequency meter. Okay, so by adjusting that frequency meter, you can adjust for the particular frequency. Now that signal will travel through the slotted line section. You may have a plunge, okay, and by using that probe, okay, you can connect the crystal detector over here. So that detector will detect the frequency and it is given to the thermistor mount, okay, and we have the power meter, okay, for getting the output, taking the output. Here the slotted line, the other side, there is again the provision for connecting the other component. Over here we need to only measure this attenuation value, so there is no need of that part and I am connecting that with the matching load. Okay, so that is why the match load termination is connected. So what is this? It's a step. It's a setup number one. Now in the setup number one, there is no device under the test. Now the second method, second setup. In the second setup, you can see that the microwave source providing the microwave signal given to the attenuator, providing the certain amount of the attenuation, given to the frequency maker measuring the frequency, and there is the device under test or the device whose attenuations to be measured, okay, and that output is given to the slotted line. So you can have the two values that before not connecting the DUT, okay, you have a certain attenuation value, certain power level, and after connecting the device under test, you have a certain output value. So that what we can do, we can just take the ratio of this two setup values and we can have the idea about the attenuation, that while the device is connected, it will provide some amount of the attenuation, okay, so that the signal power level that can be also changed. Okay, so this is the method. What is the drawback of using this method? Okay, so the power and the attenuation measurements may not be accurate when the input power is low and the attenuation of the network is large. Okay, so we can say that this is the drawback for using this power ratio method. So by this we are able to use the various method for measuring the attenuation which would be appear in the particular system. Okay, so it is about the measurement of the attenuation. Okay, so thank you very much, everyone.